Now that you've been introduced to data types, let's look at the many options of visual encodings that we have. Simply put, visual encodings are a mapping from data to display elements. The visualization that we saw before shows the correlation between income per person and life expectancy in many different countries. This graphic is rich with visual encodings. Let's take a look at some of those visual encodings now. Life expectancy is encoded visually along the y-axis, while spending per person is encoded along the x-axis. For a data visualization, this means that countries that are located in the top right corner of the graph, like Qatar, have a high income per person and high life expectancy. The opposite would be true for the countries in the lower left of the graph. Position is considered a planar variable because it locates points in space. It's probably one of the most prominent visual encodings that you'll see in data visualizations, and it's also a display element that we can perceive with great accuracy. So we know that position can be good for encoding two variables, but what do we do if we want to visualize higher dimensions of the data? Say a third variable. Well, we could visualize a third variable in the third dimension, so along the z-axis here. However, 3D models are generally poorly perceived by our eyes, as it's more difficult to make quantitative comparisons between points. For example, I'm not so sure which of these two points has a greater y value or height. So we need some other way of encoding some third variable for our data visualization. Fortunately, we have some other display elements that we can use instead. We can use what are called retinal variables to encode additional variables for a dataset. Size is an example of a retinal variable, and it's particularly good for ordered data. Going back to our World Health data visualization, we can see that population is encoded by the size of each of the circles, or more precisely, by the area of each point. In combination with color, the size attribute makes some countries more recognizable, such as India, China, and the United States. Size and color hue, which we just saw in the visualization, are both examples of retinal variables. And if we wanted to, we can even encode additional variables in these other retinal variables. Size, orientation, and color saturation are particularly effective for ordered data. However, it may be difficult to perceive quantitative differences using these visual encodings. The perceived value difference between, say, light blue and light blue isn't so obvious. These other retinal variables, such as color hue, shape, and texture, are great for encoding nominal variables. For our gapminder visualization, we can see that color hue encodes the geographical regions of the world. This choice of color makes it easier to compare income and life expectancy across developed and less developed countries of the world. The last variable we need to address is time. Now, time isn't a static display element like color, size, or position. Instead, time is animated through individual frames in our visualization. The quick succession of these frames shows change in life expectancy, income per person, and population over time. It's the remarkable and engaging aspect of this visualization, and we'll learn how to incorporate this type of dynamic visualization in Lesson 4. Now that you've seen one example of how to map data to display elements, we're going to see if you can do it for two more visualizations.